Sajjan Singh versus State of Rajasthan, AIR 1965, SC 845. Facts of the case. सज्जन सिंह को 10 फरवरी 1948 को इंस्पेक्टर जनरल ऑफ पुलिस ऑफ जयपुर के द्वारा सब इंस्पेक्टर के तौर पर अपॉइंट किया गया। फिर सितंबर 1951 में इंस्पेक्टर जनरल ऑफ पुलिस ऑफ राजस्थान द्वारा इसको कंफर्म किया गया कि सज्जन सिंह को सब इंस्पेक्टर के रूप में अपॉइंट किया गया है। लेकिन सज्जन सिंह के ऊपर कुछ कॉम्प्लेंट्स आने की वजह से एक इंक्वायरी बिठाई गई और इंक्वायरी के बाद सज्जन सिंह को 11 अगस्त 1953 में द डेप्यूटी इंस्पेक्टर जनरल ऑफ जयपुर रेंज ने उसे डिसमिस कर दिया उसके पोस्ट से। फिर सज्जन सिंह ने अंडर आर्टिकल 226 ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एक पिटीशन दायर किया ऑन द ग्राउंड दैट ही वाज नॉट गिवन सफिशिएंट अपॉर्चुनिटी टू एक्सप्लेन हिज कंडक्ट एंड ही हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड बाय द इंस्पेक्टर जनरल ऑफ पुलिस बट द डेप्यूटी जनरल ऑफ पुलिस ऑफ जयपुर रेंज had no authority to pass an order of his dismissal. Appeals against the dismissal of Sajjan Singh under Article 226 were rejected twice on 26 June 1954 and 9th January 1956. And finally, the case reached the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court considered the aspect of the case in Bhup Singh versus State of Rajasthan. Civil writ petition number 31 of 1955 decided on 6th of September 1956. Supreme Court held that under Article 311, no person shall be dismissed or removed or reduced in rank from his service except after an enquiry in which he has been informed of the charges against him and given a reasonable opportunity of being heard in respect of those charges. And a person shall not be dismissed or removed from his service by an authority subordinate that by which he was appointed. Here in this case, Sajjan Singh was appointed by Inspector General of Police, but he was dismissed by Deputy General of Jaipur Range. The petition was allowed and the order of dismissal passed by the Deputy General Jaipur Range on 11th of August 1953 was declared unconstitutional and was thereby set aside. The petitioner Sajjan Singh was to get his cause from the State of Rajasthan. Apart from it, in this case, the 17th Amendment Act was also challenged because 17th Amendment Act ke dwara Article 31A ko amend kiya gaya aur 44 naye acts 9 schedule mein laye gaye. 9 schedule mein wo acts se jo judicial scrutiny se bahar hai. Isse pehle Union Government ne First Amendment se Article 31A aur 31B laya jisse right to property ko restrict kiya gaya. Tab right to property bhi ek fundamental right tha aur iske wajah se bahut sare logon ne alag alag high courts par writ petition file kar rahe the aur bahut sare writ petition Supreme Court mein bhi file kar rahe the ki un logon ka fundamental right to property abridge ho raha hai, hanan ho raha hai aur 17th amendment se 31A ko amend kiya gaya aur साथ ही कई एक्स 9 शेड्यूल में लाया गया इसलिए ये मैटर सुप्रीम कोर्ट पहुंचा। Challenging the 17th Constitutional Amendment Act 1964 is constitutional or unconstitutional. The main contention before the 5-judge bench of the Supreme Court was that the 17th Amendment limited the jurisdiction of the high courts and therefore required ratification by one half of the states under the provisions of Article 368. The court unanimously disposed of this contention, but members of the court chose to deal with a second submission that the decision in the Shankari Prasad case should be reconsidered. The Chief Justice Gajendra Gadkar, delivering the view of the majority by 3-2, expressed their full concurrence with the decision of the earlier case. It means that under Article 368, Parliament had power to amend the Constitution. When Article 368 confers on Parliament the right to amend the Constitution, the power in question can be exercised over all the provision of this Constitution. It would be unreasonable to hold that the word law in Article 13 Clause 2 takes in Constitution Amendment Acts passed under Article 368. Dissenting from the majority, Justice J.R. Madhukar in his dissent for the first time expounded basic feature of the Constitution in this case. Quote, it is also a matter for consideration whether making a change in a basic feature of the Constitution can be regarded merely as an amendment or would it be in effect rewriting a part of the Constitution and if the latter would be within the purview of Article 368. Question mark unquote. If you like the video, give me thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe the channel. Share the information. Aapne mujhe samay diya, isliye bahut bahut dhanyawad.